You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, August 4th, 2020. It is also the feast day of St. John Vianney. Now, St. John Vianney is a French man who was a priest in the same parish for many, many years. In fact, he's oftentimes referred to as the Cure d'Ars, which means the parish priest in the city of Ars. Now, he lived a rather humble life. He wasn't known for being any sort of a genius, but he was a very holy man. In fact, he soon became known as a reader of souls. People would come from all around to have St. John Vianney hear his confession, because in the confession, he would give the most marvelous insights to people and the best guidance so that they might avoid sin. The little parish that he was the priest of in France had a total transformation with him at the helm. And so today, on the feast day of St. John Vianney, please spend a moment praying for your own parish priest. St. John Vianney is a great intercessor for them, because being a parish priest is difficult. You deal with a lot of unpleasant things sometimes, and yet it is so essential for our own faith lives. We should be so thankful and so willing to support them in prayer. Now, if you remember, this week we are going through the Eighth Commandment, which commands us to be truthful and to avoid lies or any sort of falsehood. So today we are going to talk about why lies are so devastating. Sometimes when we are in that moment where we want to get away with something, or we want to tell a sneaky lie so we don't hurt someone's feelings, perhaps, we tell ourselves that lies aren't that big of a deal. I tell this, no one will know, it's for the better. But being honest is always better. And here is a little story for you so that you can understand how telling a little lie can have huge and terrible repercussions. So once there were two friends, Nick and Jake, and they were very good friends. They'd been friends for a long time. In fact, they had gotten to the point where they didn't just talk about sports and school. But Nick has started to share about Jesus Christ, someone that Jake didn't even know about, and he was trying to convince him of how good it was to have a relationship with Jesus. He had even invited Jake to come to Mass with him. Well, it came to the point where Jake was having a birthday party. Jake didn't have very many close friends, so he invited just a couple, and of course, he invited Nick. However, Nick had been invited to something else on that exact same day, and it was with boys from school that were a lot cooler than Jake, people that he really wanted to start hanging out with. So he told a little lie. He told Jake that he actually couldn't come that day, that his family would be out of town, and he was so sad and disappointed. Secretly, he had decided to go to this other party that would be much cooler. Well, Jake accepted this. Why would his friend lie to him? It went on. But then later that week, when they were back at school, it was revealed that Nick had gone to this other party and had lied to his friend, Jake. Well, Jake was, of course, hurt. But it wasn't just that. He began to question everything that Nick had told him. Question all of their time together, but also question his motives for everything. Why had he begun telling him about Jesus? Why had he invited him to Mass? Was he his friend at all? Did he care about him? Would he just ditch him at the first sign that someone cooler wanted to be with him? Jake really struggled with this, and although he tried to get back to the friendship that he had had with Nick, he found he couldn't, and soon the two weren't friends anymore at all. Now, I know that this is perhaps a story that you can relate to. Maybe you've been in this situation where you have to choose between a friend or someone that seems cooler and more exciting. But I want you to hear from this, my friends, about how being honest in this situation would have been hurtful, sure, but it would have been so much better. When we tell lies, we destroy the trust between ourselves and another person. And not only will that friendship or relationship be damaged, but everything that we have shared with them in the past, even the important things about perhaps our faith and Jesus Christ, all of those things will be thrown into question. Everything that we have shared with them will be reevaluated, and we'll wonder if that was honest. If they lied to me here, maybe they weren't honest there as well. So being honest, being dedicated to the truth, is essential in every relationship that you have. Now, tomorrow we're going to talk about how we don't always have an obligation to share the full truth, especially when it's personal, with every single person on the planet, and how we do need to protect ourselves. But for now, I just want you to reflect on your own friendships. Are you lovingly truthful with your friends? And perhaps, is there a situation in your past where you told what felt like a little white lie to a friend, but you realized it had bigger consequences? Is this something that you need to go speak to your friend about, or perhaps bring to the confessional and ask for absolution? Regardless, spend time thinking about this and how lies have perhaps played a role in your own relationships.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing. We'd like to invite you to come and check out The Creed, which is a series for parents and children to use in the home during this uncertain time in the fall. It is an in-depth look at all that we believe, which we profess in the Nicene Creed each Sunday at Mass. It is made for the whole family, has some fun printables to go along with it. It will be very easy to use no matter which point you are with your own faith. And it is on sale right now for just $7 for the whole bundle, which will take you from September all the way up into Advent. So check the notes for this podcast episode for the direct link to find more details.